Party and for every Labour supporter. It's the result everyone always fears. I think there's absolutely no point in blaming the electorate. Any suggestion that they didn't, quote-unquote, get it is wrong. They didn't want what was being offered. I think that both in 2010 and in 2015, Gordon and then Ed allowed themselves to be portrayed as moving backwards from the principles of aspiration and inclusion that are at the absolute of heart of any successful progressive political project. The answer is not to go back to 1997, it's to build on the achievements and remedy the weaknesses, but never to end up in a position where the electorate think that you're going backwards rather than addressing the issues of the future.
You think Labour's lost the middle class, that it should return to a more Blairite agenda?
I think that the fundamental principles of an aspirational and inclusive politics are about middle class, working class and upper class. And it's very, very important in a modern society, which does have deep inequalities, but whose structure is very much changed, that we set out not to win arguments about how you have a dynamic economy, how you achieve social reform, how you modernise politics, how you play a part. Britain needs to play a part in the international system, and that needs to be done in a way that embraces people rather than divides them. And the lesson of the election, the lesson of the voters, is that we failed to do that in 2010 and in 2015.
As this debate progresses, what is your personal role? Are you going to stay on the sidelines in New York, or do you plan to return to Britain and put your name forward as a possible leader of the Labour Party?
I'm clearly not a candidate in this leadership election. I'm here in New York. I'm running a global charity that's delivering aid to millions of people around the world. The commitment I have to the job I've got doesn't change as a result of the election. What I passionately hope for is that friends and colleagues who are in the UK now will take up the mantle of a dynamic progressive politics that's able to speak to millions of people around the country. And maybe I'll be freer to contribute to that debate because there isn't going to be the soap opera associated with my name and Ed's name. And I hope to be able to do so. But obviously, I'm based here now, and it's going to be for leadership candidates to put themselves forward in a way that really does speak to the need to move Labour forward as well as move Britain forward.
Was that an uncomplicated decision? I know you spent the weekend away in upstate New York, a good time, place to think. Was that always going to be your decision?
Yes, because I made a commitment here that I'm only 18 months into. It's very, very important that I fulfil the commitments I've made here. The passion that I've got for Britain and for Labour is undimmed. It's as strong as ever. But it's clear that I'm not a Member of Parliament. I took that decision not to be part of a soap opera over the last 5 years. I wanted Labour to be able to have that debate in a clear way, make its case in a clear way, without any suggestion of distraction from me. And I hope now people can listen to what I say as someone who's trying to contribute, but obviously isn't a party to the race that's going on.
I wonder whether you've spoken to your brother Ed since the election. I don't want to intrude in the private conversation, but I wonder whether you could give us a gist of what was said between you.
Well, I'm very happy to say that we remain in touch. Obviously, I think that many of the attacks on him were unpleasant and unfair, and I think he dealt with them with enormous dignity and with courage. I've always said that I'll keep our private conversations private, but I've also always said that you remain brothers for life, and that's something that has to be kept.
Did Labour sow the seeds of its defeat back in 2010, when it decided to elect Ed Miliband as leader rather than David Miliband?
To be absolutely honest, for my own sanity, there's no point in trying to press the rewind button in life. You don't get second chances at things. You don't get to rewrite to rewind the tape. And I think it's important not to fall into that trap. I don't know what the future holds. What I know is that the values and commitments that I've made are ones that I hold dear, and I want to see through both here and wherever I can find an appropriate place to take them forward.
And who should now be the standard bearer of your brand of Labour politics?
Well, I hope that a range of leadership candidates will come forward. I'm not here to endorse any candidate. What I think is vital is that there is absolutely no delusion about what happened, why it happened, the scale of the challenge that exists, not just in England and Wales, but in Scotland as well.